Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. If you like filmmaking content or things about DaVinci Resolve, you could consider subscribing to the channel. Also, if you want my gear recommendations, please look down in the description below. So in this video, we are going to have a little bit of a basic look on if you are doing, for instance, YouTube videos and you're using the same elements over and over again, and you are creating new projects every time, you have to import all the stuff you are needing every time. So in this video, I'll show you how to set up a project so you only have to open that one every time you do a new video. Without further ado, let's get right to the video. Okay, so let's get right to it here in DaVinci Resolve. So first off, we're going down to this house here, and we are just going to start up a new project. And we are going to call this DaVinci Resolve preset. Let's call it that, and let's just begin on that. So now we're just starting on a new project, and then I'll go down to the gear icon here, and I'm just going to set my frame rate, and I always make things in 24 frames, and then also if optimized media, I'm using that, I'll change that to DNX HR HQ, and I'll do that also for the render catch, and all the other settings are just as usual. Okay, so let's start by making a project here. Okay, so let's just go out here, and I know I am using this all of the time, a lower third. So I'm going to add that in. And I'm also using this animation for my end of the videos. So this is the first things I'm always using in my YouTube videos, at least, and this one. Okay, so now they are in the media pool, and let's start importing more stuff I need. Okay, so let's just go here, and let's go to my computer, and I'll go into, this is all the recordings I do. So I'll just do a timeline just for the sake of it. So this is all my screen recordings. I use these all of the time. And I also like to cover up the bottom of the screen, and I do that with a solid color. And so first off, I'm just going to crop this down. So I'll just zoom in a bit here, and then I will just make it fit here. So I do this on most of my videos, the tutorials I do, something like that. Just that this is information you don't need. So, and then I'm just going to drag this solid color up in the media pool, going to delete it. And then I'm just going to rename this. Let's call it black bar, and now I can just drag it in, and it is already done, and I don't have to do this every time. So first off, I'm just going to delete the footage and the timeline. So now let's continue on this route of getting things into our project. So in this case, I might want to have some transitions. So let's just go in here. I'll push the house icon, and then I just need to make sure that this project has dynamic project switching, which it has. And then I'll just go to the project I need to take something from. So I have a lot of projects, and I did some transition tutorials. And let's just take a transition from, let's take this transition from our visuals I have here. So I'm just going to open up the project. There we go. And then I'm just going to highlight this, all of this, and I'm just going to push Control C to copy it all. Yeah, Control C. And then I'm going up here to the project, and I'm going to switch back to the preset I just did. And then we're going to switch back to that project. like so, and then I am just going to add in a new bin, and I'm just going to call this transitions, and then I'm just going to open that, and I'm just going to control V the transition pack into the project. So now I have that all in my project here. Okay, and then I'll just continue this route of organizing my projects by making a new bin, and I'll call this tutorial graphic. This is just the graphic I use, and I have that already here. So I'm just going to drag these three down into this bin just to organize things a bit. And I'll do another bin like there, and let's call that footage, which is just my tutorial footage of me talking. And then I'll add another bin here, and that'll be B-roll. That's, if I have any B-roll, I'll put that into that bin like so. And then again, for my purpose, I need to add a bin more, and let's call that screen recordings. Like so. And I don't do this too often in my videos. I don't use music too often, but in any case, I will just make a bin with music on. So now it's just a question of, saving this project. And when I do open a new project, I will open up this file. And then before I start to import the footage, I'm just going to rename that into the name of the new project. Anyway, this was just a super quick way look at how you can work with the templates, making a template for your project and making things a lot easier. Anyway, if you found this video useful, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it will help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on the channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.